Hi, I'm Alicia, and today we're going to learn about WordPress permissions. WordPress file permissions are essential to your site's security and functioning, so you must understand them. If you're using WordPress hosting, your host has almost certainly configured things for you already, but it's still helpful to understand these concepts if you run into any issues. So whether you've never heard of file permissions or you're just looking for the correct file permissions for WordPress, we've got you covered in this video. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, now, let's get to it. In a nutshell, file permissions control how different users can interact with the files on your WordPress site's server. More specifically, file permissions control who can read, write, and execute files. Read, the ability to read the contents of a file. Write, the ability to alter a file. Execute, the ability to use a file. There are three different types of users. Owner, the assigned owner of the file or directory. Group, members of the group that owns the file or directory. Public, all users other than the file owner or members of the group. Each file or folder is owned by a specific user or a particular group. Each user can be a member of multiple groups, but they can have only one primary group. For example, when you connect to your site via SFTP, you are using a user account on your server, and that user account belongs to one or more groups, depending on how your server is configured. Note, most people don't need to grasp the user's concept because your host configures all of this for you. However, understanding it is essential to learn the functioning of file permissions. If you feel a little lost in this section, know that in most cases, your host has appropriately set up users for your server environment. With file permissions, you can control what each type of user can do to the files and folders on your server. In general, owners of the file should have the most permissions. Users who belong to the same group would have the same or fewer permissions. Public users would have the same or fewer permissions than the group. The idea of file permissions is very similar to the WordPress roles and capabilities system. If you're the administrator of your site, you have more control than the editor. Administrators can install new plugins, for example, but an editor cannot. Similarly, an editor has a lot more control than an anonymous visitor to your site, even if the editor doesn't have as much power as a full administrator. For instance, an editor can edit other people's blog posts and publish new blog posts, but an editor can't install new plugins. File permissions are represented by a three-digit number called a permission mode. Each digit in the number corresponds with what a specific user can do. The first digit controls what an owner can do. The second digit controls what user accounts in the user's group can do. The third digit controls what everyone else can do, the public. Each digit in the permission mode is the sum of the numbers assigned to each action. Read is 4, write is 2, execute 1. If you want to grant no permissions, use the number 0. Again, the number you see in the permissions mode is the sum of all the permissions that an entity has. For example, if the owner can read and write, the permissions mode would be 6. Or if an owner has all three permissions, it would be 7. Thus, 777 is the most permissive configuration. It means that the first digit 7, owner, can read, write, and execute. The second digit 7, group, can read, write, and execute. And the third digit 7, public, can read, write, and execute. For this reason, you'll pretty much never want to set any permissions to 777 on your WordPress site. If you want to play around with this idea, you can use the change mode calculator tool to see how the numbers change as you assign different permissions to different users. While you'll probably encounter the number format most often, you'll also sometimes see file permissions represented by letters and dashes, like in this example. Here's how this format works. R is read permissions, W is write permissions, X is execute permissions. The hyphen is no permissions. There are 9 characters total. The first 3 apply to the owner, the next 3 apply to the group, and the last 3 apply to the public. In this format, the equivalent of 777 would be RWX, RWX, RWX. Because file permissions control what different users can do to the files on your server, they play a critical role in WordPress security. Imagine if you set all of your site's files and folders to 777. That would mean that anyone can create new files, modify existing files, delete existing files, execute scripts, and more. People could add malicious scripts to your site and execute them, which would quickly lead to all kinds of issues. That would be a nightmare. However, file permissions are a balancing act, and if you're too restrictive, your site would also stop working. For example, if you set your permissions to 000, your WordPress site would stop functioning entirely because your site wouldn't even be able to read any of the files on your server. For that reason, the optimal file permissions for WordPress are always going to fall somewhere between 000 and 777. File permissions can also be tricky, though, because even within more realistic scenarios, you still might encounter problems. For instance, 444 is a very secure setup for your site's htaccess file. However, if you do set it up like this, you're probably going to run into issues with some plugins that need to be able to write to your site's htaccess file, such as caching plugins like WP Rocket and W3 Total Cache. So if you're using one of those plugins that need write access, you might need to switch to a slightly more permissive 644 or even 666, depending on how your web server is configured. The short answer is that most people don't need to change file permissions manually. If you installed WordPress using your host's auto-installer, any good host should automatically set up the optimal file permissions for you as part of that setup process. If you use the WordPress installer here at Kinsta, for instance, you can be confident that we're setting up all the correct file permissions. That's part of what we do as managed WordPress host to make your life easier. So if you use your host's auto-installer and your WordPress site is working fine, you probably don't need to tinker around with your site's file permissions. However, issues might come into play if you manually install WordPress yourself. You may also experience trouble with file permissions during plugin installation and use, like our caching plugin example from the previous section. In this section, we'll talk about the correct file permissions for WordPress. Then, if you need a helping hand, we'll show you how to change them in the next section. First, it's important to note that the optimal file permissions depend in part on how your hosting environment is configured. What's optimal and secure for one environment won't necessarily be so for other environments. This is especially true for shared hosting using SUExec. In general, a good rule of thumb to account for this is to start with the least permissive configuration and only add permissions as needed to make things work. For example, when talking about the wp-config.php file, you'll see values anywhere from 400 to 644. If you're not sure where to start, you can begin with 400, as long as you recognize that this setup might cause problems with your server configuration, and you might need to make it more permissive if you run into problems. And no matter what, you should never set the permissions for anything to 777. Unless you're an expert and you have excellent reason for doing so. In general, the correct file permissions for WordPress should be as follows. Files, 644. Folders, 755. However, there are a few specific exemptions that are important to note. wp-config.php file, htaccess file, nginx.config file. Your site's wp-config.php file is a super sensitive file containing your site's database credentials and a bunch of other important information. A good starting point for the wp-config.php file is 644, which is what we use at Kinsta. However, you'll find a lot of other recommendations here, including 640 and 600. To lock it down more, some people even use 444. However, if you use 444, you might cause problems as many WordPress plugins rely on write access for the wp-config.php file. Your site's htaccess file is another vital configuration file that deserves special attention. A good starting point for htaccess permissions is 644, which is what the WordPress codex recommends. Some developers also recommend 444. However, if you use 444, it might restrict plugins that need to write the htaccess file, such as most caching plugins. Note, if you're hosting with Kinsta, you won't have a htaccess file, as we use Nginx web server for improved performance. htaccess files are only a feature on Apache web servers. You don't have to worry about htaccess permissions if you're hosting at Kinsta, because there's no htaccess file in the first place. The same htaccess file permissions also apply to nginx.config, which is the main configuration file of your host using an Nginx web server, such as Kinsta. Here at Kinsta, we use 644 for this nginx.config file. Some developers also recommend 444. If you want a quick, non-technical way to check your site's file permissions to see if you have any issues, you can use the free iTheme security plugin at wordpress.org. You can also use FTP or cPanel file manager, which we'll show you in the next section. We're first just sharing this plugin as a quick way to detect potential issues. Once you've activated the plugin, go to Security, then Settings, and click the Show Details button under File Permissions. Here, you'll find your current WordPress file permissions and how they compare to iTheme's security's recommended file permissions. You can see that iTheme's recommends 444 for the wpconfig.php file and the nginx.config or htaccess file. Remember, though, that 444 will cause conflicts with some plugins, so you might want to avoid using this. If you don't want to continue using the plugin after the setup, we recommend deleting it. Now, let's talk about how you can change your WordPress site's file permissions if needed. There are several different methods that you can use. If you know how to use FTP or SFTP to connect to your server, any quality FTP client should let you quickly change file permissions. We'll show you how it works using FileZilla, a popular free and open source client. Once you've connected to your server using SFTP, right-click on the file or folder you want to edit and choose file permissions. Then you can either use the checkboxes or enter the number directly. If your host provides cPanel, you can use the cPanel's file manager tool to edit WordPress file permissions. In the cPanel file manager, right-click on the file or folder you want to edit and choose Change Permissions. Then check the relevant boxes to assign permissions. As you do so, you'll see the totals change at the bottom. Set the correct permissions and you are good to go. So if you're manually installing WordPress or if something has messed up your site's original file permissions, you might need to edit your site's file permissions. In general, the WordPress directory permissions should be 755 and WordPress file permissions should be 644. Some crucial exceptions include your site's wpconfig.php file and your server's htaccess or nginx.config file, which you can make slightly less permissive. And no matter what, make sure you're never setting file permissions to 777 on a live site, even if you know what you're doing. Doing so would open up your site and your server to colossal security vulnerabilities. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.